everyone. This is your video on atrial tachycardia. I got this request from Vanessa, so here it is. If you guys remember, I talked about the three types of tachycardias. They were sinus tachycardia, ventricular tachycardia, and atrial tachycardia. And they're so simple because remember, the heart can only do four things. It can either be too fast or too slow or regular or irregular. So this is atrial tachycardia. I want us to start by taking a look at what it actually looks like, what you will see on the ECG strip. So here it is. Now, atrial tachycardia is just like what it sounds. You have a tachycardia, which means the heart is doing what? Right? It's beating too fast, and the problem is starting somewhere in the atrial area. Now, if you noticed on the ECG strip, you still have your P wave, and you still have a QRS complex for every P wave. So although the heart is beating too fast, the rhythm still is regular. Now, unlike sinus tachycardia, with atrial tachycardia, the problem is somewhere in the atrium, so you can expect your patient to have some sort of cardiac or pulmonary disease to go along with this rhythm strip. If you think about back to where sinus tachycardia was, the problem was somewhere on the outside of the heart causing it to beat too fast, but with atrial tachycardia, the problem is on the inside of the heart. What are the signs of atrial tachycardia? Well, your patient's going to have the normal signs of somebody who has chest distress, right? They're going to be sweaty or diaphoretic. They'll complain of dizziness or syncope. You may say, I feel like my heart is racing. And on the ECG, you'll see they have sustained tachycardia. All right, those are your signs of atrial tachycardia. Now, let me just say this. Atrial tachycardia is very uncommon. It is very rare. I don't suspect that you will see this on NCLEX. Another thing about atrial tachycardia is that it is a very generalized term because the problem can be any number of things within the atrium. All right, so I want you guys to think of abdominal pain. When somebody comes into the emergency room complaining of abdominal pain, it's like, it could be anything, right? It could be their gallbladder, it could be their spleen, it could be pancreatitis, it could be indigestion, it could be GERD. That's how it is with atrial tachycardia. It could be sinus node reentry atrial tachycardia, it could be tricuspid anomalous atrial tachycardia, it could be coronary sinus atrial tachycardia. So atrial tachycardia is just a very broad term for somewhere along the atrium, there's a problem. How do we treat it? Well, the number one thing that you need to do is, number one, confirm that it is atrial tachycardia, and that's not something that typically new nurses can do, so that's why I don't suspect this strip to be on NCLEX. How do we treat it? Well, remember, there's always two ways to treat a problem. There's a medical and a surgical, so that's why on units you see a medical intensive care unit and a surgical intensive care unit. So our medical treatment is going to be IV beta blockers, okay? You guys know those. Our surgical treatment is going to be ablation. And what an ablation is basically sending a direct shock or current to the atrium. That's going to be the most beneficial way to reprogram the heart to beat at a normal, regular pace. Our NCLEX tips are: atrial tachycardia and sinus tachycardia look so much alike that it is really sometimes very difficult for nurses, whether you're experienced or unexperienced, to distinguish them because they both have P waves and they both have QRS complexes with them. Now, the difference is with atrial tachycardia, that P wave is going to look abnormal. All right, it's going to be a little bit morphed. And so that's why, again, I don't suspect this one to be on NCLEX because it's very hard to distinguish between the two. The second thing is you never want to use vagal maneuvers, okay, or digoxin to treat atrial tachycardia. The third thing is, guess what common medication could cause atrial tachycardia? Can you guys think of one? It's a cardiac medicine. We give it a lot. We study it for NCLEX. We have to know the toxicity signs of it. Digoxin, that's right. If you give your patient digoxin and they become digoxin toxic, their ECG will show atrial tachycardia. All right, so those are the three types of tachycardia. I have finished the series. Thank you guys. Thank you my YouTube subscribers for the video requests. Subscribe, comment, like this video, send in more suggestions, and I will see you later. Bye-bye.